Ladies and gentlemen, the president of the Tampa Bay Gay Men's Chorus, Mr. Don Creamer.
Just to have announcements. They didn't give me good material, but bear with me. Thanks for coming out tonight and allowing us to be part of your holiday celebration. We hope you get that tradition that that you'll follow through each year. We'd love to see you here every year. I have a few announcements of upcoming events, and there are many. On Thursday, December 29th, the Tampa Bay Gay Men's Chorus and the Tampa Bay Performing Arts Center are proud to present for the first time in Tampa, La Grande Chaîne Opera Company. Now, I know I probably just lost 3/4 of you when I said the O word, opera. It's not like that though. This is a really fun night because this very talented all-male troupe of performers poke fun of opera. So get your tickets soon. There are still a few available by calling the chorus line, which is listed in the program, or the box office here at the Performing Arts Center. On February 17th, 18th, and 19th, we bring back the always popular cabaret. This year, it's going to be at the Hillsborough Community College Performing Arts Building in Ybor City. The title of the show is The Big Broadcast, Radio is Back, and Now You Can See It. We're going to whisk you back to 1944 in our tribute to the golden age of radio. I have a feeling the Andrews sisters may make an appearance. Maybe. In April, the national tour of the Tony Award-winning Broadway show Angels in America, Parts 1 and 2, Millennium Approaches and Perestroika, is going to be at the Sarasota Van Wezel Hall. It's bound to be sold out. If it isn't already, it will be soon. And as a fundraiser, the chorus has purchased a limited number of tickets, choice seats in the orchestra, that we're going to make available to the subscribers. So, if you're not on our mailing list, please do fill out a form in the lobby before you leave, and we'll be sending you our subscription brochure around the 1st of January. And in June, and we're really excited about this, we present our 8th annual Pride concert. We're going to be moving from the Playhouse here to next door at the 2,400-seat Festival Hall. To help us celebrate the move, we have asked the nationally renowned jazz recording artist, Ms. Diane Shore, to join us on stage, and she has accepted. I'd like to also thank our generous sponsors that made this tonight's concert very possible, the Florida Arts Council, the Arts Council of Hillsborough County, the Gazette, Tracks, Home and Garden, and a special friend of the chorus who whipped out some of the costumes you've seen here on the singer, Joe Bruno. Thank you. As Ken usually tells you at our concert, if I seem a little flustered, it's because I'm not quite over that first number in the second act. I was dressed as the mummy, and the costume gave me the wedgie of death. Flustered because I'm not sure if it was uncomfortable or if I really enjoyed it. So. Anyway, as Ken usually announces at our concerts, we're always looking for new members to join our chorus, either to sing or to help behind the scenes. If you do not like to have fun, if you don't enjoy meeting people, and if you don't get a charge out of showing off on stage, girlfriend, do not sign up, okay? But if you think you'd like to give it a try, sign up at the booth in the lobby before you leave, okay? We'd really love to see you. Auditions are January 9th. On behalf of the artistic director, Ken Williams, our executive director, Mark Quigg, my fellow board members, and the staff and members of the Tampa Bay Gay Men's Chorus, I'd like to extend our sincerest wish for a warm and very happy holiday to all of you. I'd also like to wish you a very happy, healthy, and prosperous new year. It is our hope that 1995 will be filled with love, compassion, and an acceptance of each other's differences. And now, if you'll welcome back to the stage, the Tampa Bay Gay Men's Chorus for the concert finale. Mr. DeMille, we're ready for our first off.
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, Miss Esther Williams.